This here is one of the reasons that I like side clamps so much. You see, I've got the back and the front in the same screen. Yeah, Wayne, that's left-handed. And then I can come right back and tape that Ross view off and go straight to the Junior Civitan there by just sliding the screen up. So you can't do that on a rear clamp. All right, to finish the rest of this one up, this is going to be the backs. You guys know how these sleeves are sometimes. And Wayne, I wasn't trying to be a smart aleck, but you asked me last time about off contact and holding the screen and everything, so I was just going to let you know that I'm that ambidextrous word or whatever that's called. And I mean, I have put 5 or 6 jobs in the same screen before because of the amount of room you've got to move everything around. Well, I told you guys that I was going to try this, and I did, and I just had a screen up, so I put this in there, and I printed this black ink on white shirts, and I didn't get all the black ink out, but it's still a good representation of a white underbase on a white shirt, and then the glow on top of it in a 110 screen. Printed, flashed, printed. The other one that I'm getting ready to show you in the room glowing now, I did a print, flash, print on a white shirt with no underbase. So they were right. That's all I can say. I thought I had them, but I'll get them next time. See ya. Well, it doesn't look like my cam's going to show it the way that I wanted it to. But this is the one with the white underbase, and I exposed both of these with my screen burner. And that one don't look like it's even showing up. Both of them right now are like real close. But I mean, I promise you, you can't do anything without an underbase on a dark garment. I wish they showed up better, but they're not going to. Okay, there's my dip tank, and I'm trying something new in here, which I'm using some new stuff that I got from Sunny. It's like a screen wash that I get most of the ink out of my automatic stuff, but just leave the tape in it, and then what little bit of residue ink's left in there. And then this is about all the backlight that I've got, which when I built this thing here is the first time I'd ever had a backlight. I did it for 23 years without one. But those there are ghosts. As long as you can hold that screen up to the light and see through it, you don't have to put that acid on there every time to dehaze it. But make sure you can hold it up to the light and make sure it's open. And this pretty much only works with bigger screens like 86 and 110. When I get 158 and above, I go ahead and dehaze everything, especially the finer meshes. And this right here, if you've got your chemicals going right, this is how easy it should come out. And that's only if the chemicals are working right. Everything nowadays is chemicals. Okay, here's an auto. And you see the tape right off the battery's getting ready to die. Even where it's like bubbled up on both sides, you can get your finger underneath it and get it off.